2008 uprisings.
我也觉得这个问题是非常难以回答。
So yeah, I believe this is a difficult question, but I would like to give you.
因为今天提到这个314的问题，我突然那个有个感觉呀，就是那个314发生到现在大概有一年过去了，但一提到314，我就有一种这种就是一种叫什么一种 picture 那样的那个脑袋里头，因为那个314在拉萨发生314以后呢，我五月份。 去了西藏，当时我还能看到这个三幺四，就是打砸抢烧这事件带来的一些影响，比如说砸了一些商店呀、学校啊，这些情景呢，我一下子好像又浮现在我眼睛这个脑海当中了。So
even right now, this event has occurred for more than 1 year, but every time when I repeat this, the picture always in my mind to review, and as a matter of fact, just after the event in May that year, 2008, I went back to the hometown in Lhasa, and I still saw there, you know, the shops or the houses are collapsed and smashed or burned. So this is the picture I never forgot.
任何一个就是那个就向往和平的。 喜欢这种和谐宁静这样一个社会环境的人呢，都不希望，在世界任何一个地方发生那样一个事件，这是一个令人非常痛心的事情。但是这样一个事件呢，确实是在拉萨发生了。
I believe everybody around the world who are long for the peace and long for the harmonious society don't like seeing such kind of the pictures, but the fact that is it happened there.
那么刚才也问到了这个314这样一个事件，到底是内部原因还是外部原因？我想应该说这个原因是多方面的。但是呢，从那个大家可能也注意到了，这个在西藏的整个这个稳定和发展方面呢，遇到的一个很大的阻力是这个外部的一些影响。
So your question is ask whether or not that caused the internal problem or outside force. As you say, question, when everything happens, it happens not only internal, but also external. In particular, this case, to the extent of the stability of the Tibet, the outside influence is much stronger than the inside influence.
那么大家也非常清楚，这个，在这个中国境外啊，现在有一个流亡政府，还有一个达赖集团，同时也有他底下的一些像这个青年大会啊、妇联啊，像这样的一些组织，应该说他们在这个整个像拉萨这种骚乱这方面呢，起了一定的这样一个叫什么一个煽动或者这样一个作用吧。
According to our study and evidence, we found, there are many of the, outside influence or support come from the exile government of Dalai Lama and also his group, the youth group, and also women group as well.
我也不是说这个我们拉萨是就是说整个西藏没有任何问题。 西藏还是存在很多问题，因为这个西藏整个地处，大家可能也知道，在青藏高原，自然环境这个相对来说这个比较落后一些。那么整个社会制度的这种社会的这个发展的这个发育的这个程度啊，比起其他地方呢还要这个滞后一些。那么这样一些这个自然的环境、社会的这个原因啊，所带来的一些问题啊，要更多一些。但是西藏存在这些问题呢，不至于上升到把这个 发生314这样一些这个大的这种社会动乱上头。
I didn't mention here, there is no problem internally. As a matter of fact, since you know Tibetan in living in the harsh environment, which is quite inferiorly conditioned than other places around the or many of the places in the world. And in particular, Tibetan is underdeveloped. A developing area, so there are many of the problems about the natural environment, about the social society, and you know many aspects. There of course have some difficulties, but no matter how difficult it is in terms of the social difficulties or natural difficulties, but according to ours, we didn't feel that kind of the problem will really provoke such kind of the, you know, road event.
我本人也是个西藏人，就是藏族，主要做这个西藏宗教，就藏传佛教方面的研究。那么这样一个事件发生以后呢，我也到了这个从去年5月份开始就到西藏的一些寺院去调研。那么我的感觉呢，是无论是寺院的僧人也好，到一些广大这个广大信教群众也好，都不希望发生这样一些乱子来。 那么这个呢，不仅这个影响整个这种社会，整个这种发展，同时对这些寺院的这种正常的一些生活呀，也带来一些很大的一些影响。那么这些僧众也好，民众也好，都是希望不发生这样的事情。现在应该说，这个人心思定啊，是大家的一种期盼和一种最高的一种要求。
For myself, I'm Tibetan from the place of close to the Lhasa, and for myself, I'm study at the area of the religion, Tibetan Buddhism. So after the event, I went back to the Tibetan inhabited area to visit many of the monasteries and the temples, and I try to you know explore what's the problem, what is the reason, or how the people thought after this. So I interviewed so many monks and the nuns and also the people around, and the founding of the research result we found that is no matter they are monks or nuns or the peoples, they don't want this kind of turmoil, and because such kind of turmoil really you know impeded their development and even their daily life, so they really long for the peace and the stability of the society.
Next question. If you could stand up, introduce yourself, and speak loudly as you can.
I don't know if this is a question. My name is Denise Scott. Psychology major here at FBU. I'm confused. I'm trying to understand if Dalai, I can't say pronounce name, Dalai Lama. Was the purpose of his father being murdered or poisoned was to stop him from trying to take the position to be the fourth? I'm trying to figure out what was the motivation
for the poison.
Poison.
And that is a question.
And like having him was going to be the point to changing things, to make that relationship with the garment. I can't remember the name of the...
The regent. The regent.
I think we have the basic idea. Thank you.
Okay. 他的问题就是说，对刚才讲的这个还是不太了解。就是说，达赖喇嘛的那个爸爸呀，就被就害，就是毒死了。那么这个跟就是说他这个之间有什么关系？跟达赖喇嘛的这个政治有些什么样的关系？
就是在和平解放西藏以前，就是达赖喇嘛他的家族他本人处在一种比较险恶的一种环境。就是在这个地方，我就是想试图说明。 达赖喇嘛，第一，他面临着就是自己呢，可能有被废除掉，不再当达赖喇嘛，当一般的活佛，这第一个问题。第二个问题呢，在里面我讲的就是说，他没有被替换掉，还是14世达赖喇嘛。但是由于他的父亲和中央政府的关系比较好，